The video is Lila Nishmas from Shmuel Baruch and Chaim Tzvi Dov. When it first addressed the yesterday's videos, which people were fascinated by the origin of the languages and the letters, and it seemed to be somewhat of a contradiction. Is it Aramaic as the original language? What are the original letters? Are the letters the original letters that we have, which the letters that we have in the Sefer Torah, or actually some more of a script type of letters, which are similar to these? The letters that are used in Aramaic, or what's called the Shamonim's language. So the truth is, both are true, because it's a dispute. Hard to understand. The first time I saw this, Machlikas, is both quoted in the Bavli and Yerushalmi, it's in Masechet Sanhedrin, and it's in Masechet Megillah, that actually has one opinion that says that the original letterings that were in the Sefer Torah are not the letters that we have today, which we call Ksav Ashuris. Rather, it's much more script-like, like you find by the Shamonim, and similar to what this fellow was describing and has. And in fact, Ksav Ashuri, the Assyrian, or according to one explanation, the richer and more beautiful-looking letters that we have today in the Sefer Torah was introduced by Ezra HaSofer. And it represented, to some degree, as if Ezra HaSofer, during the second Beis HaMikdash, rebuilding the second Beis HaMikdash, was like Moshe Rabbeinu, who was in his level, and he was, so to speak, giving the Torah over again. So there's a lot of deep insight into that, but I just wanted to make sure that that is clear. It seems to be an interesting dispute. Now, getting back to also the Rav Chaim Kanievsky. So when we write Rav Chaim Kanievsky, I asked him 11 questions on a piece of paper. In fact, this precious little paper, this is it. Simple piece of paper with a lot of interesting questions, and he just read them and answered very quickly. One of the questions, I think, is an amazing koyach, and the theme, of course, of this the next 60 days or 59 days, as we prepare for this incredible day of Yom Purim, or like the Arizal says, Yom Kippurim, that Yom Kippurim is like Purim because it's such a high level. So, Rav Chaim Kanievsky, interesting. I asked him, one of the 11 questions that I asked is, what should people do for Shalom Bayis? There were two things, actually, that he said. One of them is he gave me a booklet. He has a new skula. It's called the Shalom Bayis Skula that discusses all the different nameless statements of Shalom Bayis. And the assumption is, I think, to learn the statements. That's number one. Number two, I was discussing where there is difficulties between husband and wife, things that unfortunately we deal with day in and day out. And he said one word. He said, lihit palil. The koyach of tefillah. Now for him, it's so pashut, but it's something that we need to strengthen ourselves all the time, and especially when it comes to Purim, as we'll see, the Koyach HaTefillah plays such an incredible role, to the degree that if you noticed in the davening on Rosh Chodesh, so when it comes to Musaf, in the end, the special bracha, when you're davening for Parnasa and Sosan and Simcha and all the different requests, and you say, Baruch Atah Hashem, Mekadosh Yisrael, Roshecho Doshim, on the word Hashem, if you're a little bit Kabbalistically in tune, so you see on the bottom, it tells you the different letterings and the order of the letters that you should have in mind. Now this is all based on actually different verses. The verse that is connected to this month of Adar is the verse that's written in the blessings of Yaakov Avinu to Yehuda that says, V'asorika b'ni asoinoi, which implies that Yaakov Avinu is describing how incredible it's going to be for Yehuda, Shevet Yehuda, which is going to have so much wine. He's going to attach his donkey to the branches, and it's going to produce a lot of wine. Now, here's the amazing thing. Yesterday, we had these videos from this guy, Sammy. And as we discussed, one of the things that always perplexed me was the word chamra. Chamara in Shas, all over, means sometimes donkey, and sometimes it means wine. But here's the amazing thing. It's connected in the Pasuk, too. Donkeys and wine. It says that Yehuda is going to attach his donkey to the vine. Why is there such a connection between the vine, between Yayin, Chamra, or Chamara, as we pointed out, it's just difference in pronunciation, but what's the connection? And there's an amazing message here. So first I'm going to let everyone think about this a little bit, because there's a deep, deep, deep thoughts here. I just want to really end off that one of the discussions that we said was Marbim B'Simcha this month is a month of Simcha, and I plead, I beg of everyone to really take this idea that we mentioned of every day getting together with your family or even privately and listing, making that list. At each day, you'll see how amazing, because it becomes more and more difficult, of things that you appreciate. So the entire month is permeating with true Simcha, really true Simcha, really giving, expressing gratitude to Hashem for the things that we have. You'll see it has an effect. has a real effect on our brain, on the chemicals in our brains, and makes us be in a much more positive light. That's number one. Now, it's interesting that of Chaim Kanievsky's father, the stipler, as we mentioned, used to give out wine. I don't know how much wine, as I said. And in today's world, not necessarily as we're still holding in fifth level pleasure, and we're going to go to fourth level pleasure very soon. The ikar is not the actions. Even though the Rogachev writes that the ikar is achila v'shtia, but as we said from Shlomo Zalman Obach, and I want to quote, it's kedai to see the words in the Dirshu, the quote, the words from the Shlomo Zalman Obach, he says the following. He says, what's called simcha? She'ein tzorech lahalbos bepulei she simcha. This is from Shlomo Zalman Obach. You don't have to do actions of simcha. The ikar hadin, this is the halacha, it's a halacha, to remove from your heart during these days all worry and sadness. That's the vort. That's what we have to work on. Have an amazing Chodesh, or continued Chodesh. Hatzlacha.